Hello. So this is our poster for our research study entitled An Uphill Climb, The Lived Experiences of Emergency Room Nurses on Stress by me, team leader Neil Efren-Batun, Angela May Mboloko, Jerica Obonete, DJ Evan Jules Di Cañada, and Joey Margaret Di Aurelio.
Background of the study. Being a nurse in 2021, specifically a Bacol City emergency room nurse, has a large number of implications. It is said that a majority of nurses working are often in the condition of being understaffed, underpaid, and overworked. This already lies a foundation upon which occupational stressors are in existence. On top of this, Bacol emergency room nurses now must deal with a crisis that is the COVID-19 pandemic, which has thrown the entire world into a fray. It is through this research that the researchers hope to not only bring light to the conditions Bacol emergency room nurses must work under, but present findings that can result in finding effective ways to help improve and reform the system in place as to lessen, if not eradicate, occupational stressors in the emergency rooms. Research design. Phenomenology was the chosen approach to the qualitative study because it would focus on the commonality of the significant experience of this particular group of nurses. Since no study has been conducted among this population in Negros Occidental, and these nurses were the first responders when it comes to critical and urgent cases, yet the stress they experienced was still high. The study design would assist to describe the factors that may impact the lived experiences of emergency room nurses and the relationship between the variables. Methods. The study would use purposive sampling to logically gather 5 to 9 emergency room nurses from different hospitals in Negros Occidental with different qualitative profiles to attain different perspectives. A researcher-made question in 2 parts would be provided to the participants. The first part would be a questionnaire to gather data to establish a qualitative profile of the respondents. A second part of the questionnaire would be the guide questions for probing. Results. Theme 1. Skills and characteristic demands of the ER. A1. What a nurse needs in the ER, skill-wise or otherwise. Riley 29 stated, you need to have 3 things. Knowledge, skill, and attitude. I think the most important one is the attitude. 1B, difficulty of being employed in the emergency room. K30 stated, it really demands high level intelligence and intelligence when dealing with people. Theme 2, occurrence of stress in the ER. 2A, whether or not stress is a factor in the experience of the emergency room. Fran 22 stated, stress maybe is a part of our lives, but as a nurse, maybe it's our sisters and brothers already. Even if you go to sleep, our mind is still at the working area. 2B, stress-inducing situations in the emergency room. Riley 21 stated, why is it that at the ER or being a nurse as a whole, why is it that stress is intertwined with your profession? It is because you imagine a person coming to you breathless, pulseless, or in a critical condition, so that a person already at the verge of breaking down physically, plus that person might not have enough money.
Moving on to main theme 3, which is impact of the pandemic on ER nurses, we have subtheme 3A, which is newfound experiences in the ER in relation to the occurrence of the COVID-19 pandemic. We have Glory 22, who states, pre-COVID, we accept all patients, no questions asked. Now we need to decrease patient count and we need to be more keen when it comes to triaging, and the anxiety will always be there when it comes to interacting with patients. In essence, she states that the COVID-19 pandemic has resulted in just another worry that ER nurses have when it comes to admitting and assessing their patients. Next, for main theme 3, we have subtheme 3B, which is the impact of COVID policy and protocols implementation on ER nurses. We have Fran 22 states, during this pandemic, we are just having protocols. Our policy is that all staff nurses should report on duty, I think 10 minutes before the time in. She goes into detail about how even before they are able to enter the ER to begin their shift, they now must go through a screening process to ensure that they are not positive for the virus. Moving on to the conclusion, working in the emergency room as a whole is not an easy task, and one must be properly prepared and proficient in a multitude of skills and areas in order to adequately provide care to those being admitted to this specific ward. Despite this, the participants of the study never seem to waver in their commitment to become quality nurses. On top of this, stress, the same way it is present in our everyday lives, is present while working in the emergency room. The current COVID-19 pandemic has also added to the tension that these nurses are experiencing, with all the participants being able to go into detail about how the pandemic has affected their lives personally and professionally. It is with this that all frontline nurses should be applauded for the courage and strength they possess in order to face the challenges they encounter day in and day out, not only serving their patients, but the population as a whole. Moving on to recommendations, providing nurses a proper means of coping with their stress or allowing nurses to de-stress should they believe to be overstressed are potentially important steps in combating the prevalence of stress in nurses in the ER. Potentially increasing the amount of participants, even by one or two participants, could have profound effects on the results of the future study. Expanding the boundaries in which participants are pulled from in the future may present a more diverse and eye-opening set of results in terms of the experiences and statements recorded by those participants. Also, changes such as location of study changes, alterations in the interview process, and even possibly the conduction of a study in post-COVID times may all serve to alter, improve, or diversify the results in a study aiming to accomplish the same goal as this research study. With that being said, that is our presentation of this poster. Thank you very much.